Yeah, thanks for everybody being here today. I stayed up late last night making a terrain model for the ops brief this morning, so I hope you all appreciate that. Mark and I'd like to do is cover just a few things that, of course, mostly answer your questions, but I'll begin with an ops update. And, of course, what most people are focused on is the most current high-profile operation. Those are operations in the Nadali district of the Helmand province along the Helmand River Valley. Marja is the name that most people have attached to that. Marja is not a separate district until it's signed. Yesterday, President Karzai made the decision that it would be a separate district, which was, of course, well received by the population. That operation, as we have outlined for people, is an effort at the tactical and operational level to regain terrain. People, really, about 75,000 people live in that particular area that's been under Taliban control for an extensive period of time, a couple of years, absolute Taliban control, to the point where there was even a flag, a Taliban flag, raising over part of it. It also was a place with extensive narco trafficking and narco production there. The military part of the operation is not over, but the high profile part of it is. The first part of the clearing operations are done. Now, clear, hold, build, and transfer. Clear will go on for months because clearing is more than actual military moving around after the enemy. It's also getting out some of their cadre. It's things like that. But we have essentially got control of the area now. And so we really have begun into the next phases, which is the hold and build. I'll let Mark talk more about that. But that's really the test of reestablishing effective governance in that area. And that's something that the population's very interested in. When we put that operation in a larger sense, it's really got a couple of things. First is it expands the security zones that we began last summer along the Helmand River Valley, Khanishin, Nawan, Garbsir, and whatnot. So it expands that significantly, and it gives people in that area a greater opportunity to have areas of contiguous security to allow them freedom of movement, but that's still a work in progress. And then it also is a chance for us to show Afghan leadership of an operation in a critical area leading towards future operations as well. A lot of people have talked about Kandahar. We are absolutely going to secure Kandahar. We already are doing a lot of security operations in Kandahar, but it's our intent under President Karzai's direction to make an even greater effort there. So we'll be expanding security for as many Afghans as we can, depending upon our force flow and that sort of thing. So it's got the operation has an operational importance, but it also has a strategic importance because we believe as it becomes a stepping stone to further ops, it's also a demonstration to the Afghan people, to the international community, to the Pakistanis, and very importantly to the Taliban as well, that things have changed. And so that's operationally. I'll stop there. I'll pass to Ambassador Sedwill.
Let me just continue from where General McChrystal left off. This operation, although others will vary, is in many ways a template for the way we want to take this campaign forward over the next year to 18 months. And that is a template essentially in three ways that are different, and why this operation is different to previous ones. And there's really three dimensions to that. Firstly, the integration between the civilian and military elements of it. This operation was planned by General Carter and his Afghan counterparts from the end game backwards, and the end game is the civilian delivery of governance and development, which is just starting. I'll talk a bit about that in a moment. But that integration between civilian and military has always been there, but is a different order of magnitude this time. Secondly is the integration between the Afghans and the international forces. As General McChrystal said, this operation was led by the Afghans, really authorized and controlled in many ways by President Karzai and his team from the start. And again, in a way, it's not binary, but is very significantly different to the way it's been in the past. A much bigger proportion of Afghan troops on the ground, and the Afghans have completely led the work on the civilian effort, the district delivery that is going to follow up with our support. And the third element that is different is the integration on the Afghan side between the provincial and the central. Previous operations of this kind, particularly in Helmand, have been have had a strong Afghan element to them, but it's been very much at the provincial level, led by Governor Mangal and his team, but really without very much support from the centre. And although they've led it again this time, and he's led it again this time, he's had a very significant support from various ministries. The Minister of Interior has been down there several times, Minister of Defence, Jalani Popal, who's in charge of local government, has been down there for weeks at a time to make sure that the central government is fully behind this. And that's why, although in some ways elements of this operation and the language that we use around this operation sounds familiar, it is qualitatively different to anything that we've tried before. As General McChrystal says, it's now moving beyond that initial military phase to secure the area into actually delivering for the population. And there's really two elements to that. The first, and the one that you'll be most familiar with, is the kind of economic and social development. There are some quick work there in terms of cash for works, getting people to refurbish and repair the bazaars to get those open again, clear the irrigation districts, do some repair work on our local clinics, local schools and so on, just to get economic and normal life going again. But the critical other pillar to this is really on the governance side. One of the reasons the Taliban were able to infiltrate this area was because the police had been, in effect, captured by some local warlords who were using them against the population, and the police were fundamentally part of the problem. And the population have said on various occasions, including again yesterday to President Karzai, that they would not accept the old police force back, and indeed would fight again should that be the case. And that provided the environment which the Taliban were able to infiltrate. And so it is absolutely critical that policing in particular from now on delivers what the people of that area require, and that is just fundamentally honest and decent policemen. That's happening now with the Afghan National Civil Order Police, ANCOP, in there and on the ground, and the people of the area are already seeing the difference between that and the police under which they had suffered in the past. But that means that a very important element of this over the next few months is as the Afghans deploy local police again, probably not from the immediate district itself, but from elsewhere in Helmand or nearby, that they are well trained and up to the same standards as the national police that they are that they're now seeing, because that is going to be one of the crucial elements, probably the crucial element, in determining the allegiance, the long-term allegiance of the people of that area, whether they go with the government and the legitimate authorities, or whether they fear that again those institutions get captured and thus decide to turn to the insurgency. And that's also true of the justice sector as well. So those are the fundamentals, and that work is in hand. President Karzai heard a lot about that from the local shura that he addressed yesterday, where people were very frank with him about their fears on that side, and he undertook to deal with those issues, allow them to form a local shura of their own that would be essentially the authoritative body representing their views and enabling him to ensure that he directed the Afghan government to fulfil their needs. Vice President Khalili last week was also down there and promised them that not only would they experience good governance now, but they would experience good governance to stay. So there's a strong commitment there, but that is going to be the test in the end of whether the work that we've done with the Afghan security forces really does succeed and endure, will be whether we can maintain that momentum through this phase. And that, of course, is the template for elsewhere. We know that many of the same problems exist elsewhere in the country, where institutions have been grabbed, essentially, by local power brokers, local warlords, who have essentially perverted their purpose and abused their power in order to inflict their own corruption and so on the people. And that dealing with those political issues, which President Karzai was very alert to, spoke to very eloquently yesterday, and indeed to us afterwards, is going to be a big part of how we need to shape this campaign going forward. So we're bringing together the political issues, civilian delivery, and the military operation to bring security to really do this differently and in a much more sophisticated way than we've managed in the past. And that's why Marja is, although an extreme example, a template for what we'll be trying elsewhere across the country with the Afghans and under their leadership.
Can we do questions just quick?